Hey, welcome back. We continue with Air Quality Awareness Week, and I'm excited, y'all. I've got the experts with me. So joining me now is Cory Chism, the Deputy Director of Monitoring with the Texas Commission of Environmental Quality. Got it right. Let's get into the fun stuff, because we've been having conversation over the last 10 minutes and I am learning a ton, and I'm excited for you to kind of inform our viewers as to what you guys do over at TCEQ. So Texas Commission on Quality. What is it? What's your role?
Sure. Well, thank you, Kristen, for having us this morning. So as the state's environmental agency, TCEQ is responsible for protecting the state's air resources and ensuring that our citizens have clean air to breathe. We do that through permitting and regulation of air emission sources, also incentivizing voluntary reductions, and then, like the stationary monitor here, monitoring air quality. We monitor air quality in a variety of ways. We have over 200 of these stations across the state located in populated areas, measuring things like ozone and particulate matter, nitrogen oxides, sulfur dioxide, pollutants that can impact the federal air quality standards and impact our daily lives. We also have monitoring vans equipped with very specialized instrumentation that we can use to actually monitor while on the move. And so we can assess areas quickly and evaluate a wide host of different contaminants that may be in the air. And then lastly, we have handheld instruments that our investigators, our field investigators, can use when they respond to localized air quality concerns or even emergencies or disasters. So by and large, we have a number of tools that we can use in our toolbox to help with air quality.
Absolutely. So this site here at Murchison Middle is just one of many. And I wanted to kind of talk a little bit about Austin, the city of Austin, because we tend to skew actually a little bit better than some of our neighboring big cities here in Texas. What in particular do we need to watch for when it comes to Austin? What are some of those problem areas when it comes to maybe pushing us to a poor air quality day?
Sure. So there are a number of different types of sources, both man-made and natural, that can impact or negatively impact air quality. For Austin, that's really vehicle emissions. Vehicle exhaust is the largest component that impacts the Austin area. But we also, as consumers, we can use things that are low or zero emission cleaning supplies or paints. That's a big help. Conserving energy, obviously our energy sources contribute. And then we have natural sources like Saharan dust events or smoke from wildfires that can impact our air quality.
And you told me something earlier that I thought was very interesting. You know, every once in a while we do see one of those ozone action alert days here in the state of Texas. But when it comes to the city of Austin, and I mentioned earlier that air quality index, how many of the unhealthy or bad air quality days have we had here in Austin recently?
Sure. So looking at data over the last 5 years, the Austin area has actually only had one day that measured in the unhealthy or that level red category, according to EPA's air quality index. And that day was actually during last June's significant Saharan dust event. So you can see the impact that would have on air quality. Apart from that, the Austin area typically experiences about 3 days where air quality might meet that level orange or unhealthy for sensitive groups range. Comparatively, looking at places like Houston or Dallas that have more emission sources and even more vehicles, they may have 3 days that meet that unhealthy or level red category.
So we're not the worst, but maybe we could do a little bit better, especially when it comes to, you know, traffic and those vehicle emissions. So thank you so much, Cory, for joining us. Coming up a little bit later, I'm going to get in this trailer, and I want to see what these instruments do. I want to see what they measure. We're going to get into the nitty-gritty science geekiness of it. So stick around.